Video games may be getting grander in scope, but with added components comes added issues. And there are a number of video games that are riddled with problems upon their release. Some manage to recover and become absolute classics. Others never get over their poor launch. In this video, we're gonna take a look at the most disastrous video game launches of all time, and see what happened to the video games after their bad launch day. And yeah, I think you can guess who's gonna be first.
Well, you ain't getting anywhere without an upgrade.
How could we start this video with anything other than Cyberpunk 2077? When CD Projekt Red announced the game, anticipation was sky high, and fans were eager to get their hands on a copy, you know, or download it, however you get your games. But every time the game seemed like it was about to hit the shelves, or the interwebs, it would undergo delay after delay after delay, much to the ire of the fanbase. So the game developers eventually seemingly gave in, and released the game despite it clearly not being ready, with it being riddled with bugs and glitches, and sometimes crashing completely, which happened to me more than once. While it was still available for sale, many gaming companies like PlayStation pulled it completely from their store, only just recently putting it back up for sale. Keeping on with more recent video game releases, while its reception wasn't as poor as Cyberpunk, Marvel's Avengers did little to live up to expectations. With the likes of Insomniac's Spider-Man and the Arkham games, there's been a heavy emphasis on top-tier superhero games, so there was a lot of hype around the Avengers. However, the game was critically underwhelming, being seen as repetitive and contained, and despite having a budget of $100 million, it only sold 60% of expected sales, and ended up being the main reason for Square Enix's $67 million operating loss. Another game that looked great in early images, but ultimately disappointed, was Anthem. BioWare has a solid reputation for making games, but the game suffered a plethora of issues during development, and when the game was released, the online multiplayer was so buggy, such as giving you the most powerful weapon in the game straight away. That doesn't seem like that big a problem. Look, it never really recovered. Because of its poor critical reception, it ended up being a financial one too, and has seemingly never managed to eke out its full potential. But perhaps the most infamous game launch, you know, other than Cyberpunk, is No Man's Sky. The hype for the game was insane, and it had a crazy amount of buzz around it for an indie game. But as they say, it's the hope that kills you. And it turned out a lot of features were actually rather over-exaggerated. Fans found it tedious and sought refunds, while critics were even less kind, labeling it as a boredom simulator. That's not good. Since its release, Hello Games have put in the work to match expectations, and a vast number of expansions have improved it, but its launch has undoubtedly tarnished the title's reputation. You know a game launches bad when politicians decide to get involved. That's what happened with EA and the launch of Star Wars Battlefront 2. The 2015 Battlefront remake was poorly received as it is, but when the sequel turned out to be arguably even worse, fans were not happy in the slightest and proceeded to review bomb it. But the main issue for the game was the vast amount of paywalls and microtransactions, which caused fans to petition online. State legislators even described the game as a Star Wars themed online casino designed to lure kids into an addictive cycle of gambling money, and said that its monetization practices were exploitative and aggressive. How's that for a first impression? Now, when I was younger, I was actually a huge fan of WWE games, in particular SmackDown vs. Raw 2007. But some of the more recent WWE games can be pretty hit and miss. But there's one game that is much more miss than hit, WWE 2K20. The game was riddled with glitches, technical issues, and hilarious bugs, and it received tons of complaints, calls for refunds, and even ended up at one point one of the worst reviewed games of all time. With a remake of the classic game SimCity in the works, it promised to help revitalize the series, but it ended up having an absolutely disastrous launch, as hours of gameplay were lost due to saving issues. The main issue, however, was having to have a network connection in order to actually play the game, which caused problems when there were network outages. Because of this, reviews were mostly negative, and critics advised fans not to purchase the game until the bugs were fixed, long after the initial release. Now, it's basically blasphemy to say anything bad against the Halo series, and while the Halo Master Chief Collection is considered great now, it didn't have the smoothest release. The series had multiple bugs and glitches that made online play awful, not to mention the amount of times the game servers couldn't even find matches. Because of this, the head of 343 Industries, Bonnie Ross, had to issue a very lengthy apology on the matter. But before 343 took ownership of Halo, it was a Bungie property. But they set sail to make a new space franchise, Destiny. Now, for the most part, people look back at Destiny with fondness. The early reviews were actually pretty poor. Peter Dinklage's voice acting was one of the first things to receive criticism, along with a fractured plot, a quote-unquote lifeless world, and what was seen as a poor campaign. Like Destiny, nowadays Final Fantasy XIV is remembered fondly, but it too didn't get a great start in life. Filled with bugs and glitches amongst it and a number of other technical issues, this caused a poor critical and commercial reception. Thankfully though, a strong reboot saved the game and made it one of the most popular in the series. Assassin's Creed is another franchise that for the most part gets pretty good reviews. However, Assassin's Creed Unity was not so lucky, and when the game launched, it was in a rather poor technical state and had a number of bugs and glitches, all of which were pretty darn funny. Because of this, Ubisoft had to issue an apology and even gave away free games, which isn't bad as far as apologies go. Alien Colonial Marines had a lot of hype around it, and marketed itself on its state-of-the-art graphics and gameplay. But the game, based on the massive film franchise, ended up being a huge flop, with the game under-delivering on multiple fronts, which nearly led to the game being sued. Like many on this list, there was great hype around Fallout 76, and it promised that it would be a game where the player's choices really mattered. The game was packed full of bugs, and on top of that, fans lost money on the Power Armor editions, which was supposed to include a burlap backpack, but was in actuality a bag made of Teflon. Now, I can't believe I'm saying this, seeing as it's one of my favorite games of all time, but Skyrim did not have the best of releases. The opening days of Skyrim was a bit of an arrow in the knee for Bethesda, and it was full of some terrible glitches and bugs, which included having players trapped in a loop. Thankfully though, Skyrim managed to mostly right their wrongs, and now it's hard not to get trapped in a mental loop playing Skyrim. Going back further in time, the release of E.T. on Atari in 1982 is notorious for going so horribly badly. In order to cash in on the success of the movie, the game was developed in 5 weeks, with 5 million copies made. The game ended up being a total mess, and many copies were quickly returned. To make matters worse, after an excavation in New Mexico in 2014, the rumor around the game stating that many copies had been buried in a landfill turned out to be true.
We found an intact E.T. the video game.
And finally, let's end on what is probably the worst video game launch title of all time. Marky Mark / INXS Make My Video. The quote-unquote game basically just had you sit down, listen to songs, and watch Marky Mark dance shirtless, and that was it.